Hello guys, my name is Tushar Goyal, and before starting the seminar, before starting the topic of the seminar, I would like to talk about Wi-Fi. So we all know about Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi transformed the digital communication, and without this technology, our current way of mobile life would be somewhat different. And also, Wi-Fi uses approximately of 60% of the internet traffic. So with all that being said, Wi-Fi still has some issues, like it gets sketchy sometimes when the signal is varied, and it is less secure because your signal can travel through walls, and can easily be picked up by someone else. So the reason for that problem is that Wi-Fi uses radio waves. So the main issues are the Wi-Fi is not totally secure and it is highly congested, which means, actually I will talk about this term after a while. So how can we improve this technology and remove this problem? We should use something which is cheap and secure and more robust for the transfer of the internet data. So the answer for that question is light. So light is just perfect because light comes under the electromagnetic spectrum, as like the radio waves, and also light has very high frequency than the radio waves. So the frequency of the light is 10,000 times greater than the frequency of the radio waves. So here, as you can see in this diagram, that this is the frequency of the radio waves and this is the frequency of the visible region, and light falls under the visible region. So which means that light is capable to transmit the very vast amount of data in a very less amount of time. So a concept in which light is used as a medium to transfer the internet data. So the concept in which light is used as a medium to transfer the internet data is called Li-Fi or light fidelity. So this is what my seminar is all about, Li-Fi technology. So how does it works? So before talking about the working of the Li-Fi, I would like to talk about the working of the television through the remote controller. So we all know that the remote control contains the infrared sensor. So this is the remote controller, and it contains a LED which is of infrared sensor, and basically switching on the light and switching off the light creates a single stream of data which can travel up to a speed of 20,000 bits per second. So but in case of Li-Fi, there are, we have thousands of streams of data which can travel at a very high speed in parallel. So as you can see, we have the LED here, the LED light here, and these are the thousands of stream of data. So LED makes up of the semiconductor. The quality of the semiconductor is that they can be modulated at a very high speed. So this is the working of the Li-Fi. So this is the architecture of the Li-Fi. So this is our whole internet system, which contains the server and the routers, and there is a hardware called lamp driver. So this is something which you have to install for the Li-Fi, and all the wires of the LED get connected to that lamp driver. Okay, as the light falls to the receiver dongle, then then it the term here, the main concept here is that the receiver should be directly under this LED light or the projected area of that LED lamp. So that's how LiFi works, and it is quite simple. LiFi ignores the constant light, which means that the constant light from that region also comes here down to the receiver, but the receiver will actually reject this constant light because this receiver is only interested in the subtle changes. So what if light is turned off? So you might be wondering, if the light has to be turned on all the time for the working of the LiFi, so how can we use this technology in the night time? So the answer of that question is, you can actually dim the light down to a certain level that the human eye cannot detect that the light is on, but the receiver can still read it. Okay. So the main attraction of the LiFi is that the speed of LiFi is 100 times faster than the Wi-Fi, and also the bandwidth is 10,000 times larger than the Wi-Fi. So the term congestion can be discussed here because as we know, mainly the main modes of communication or the main modes of digital communication uses radio waves. Okay, and it's very, and radio wave region is a very small region with a very small frequency. Okay, and it is actually get congested nowadays. So we should move on to it is compulsory for us to move on to the another technology. So so the bandwidth of the light is light region is 10,000 wider than the radio waves. So that's something we can use for the good reason. A research at Oxford University, a professor found out that the speed can be increased up to a speed of 224 gigabytes per second. It's a speed in which you can download 18 high definition movies in 1 second. So it's a quite interesting thing. And whether or not servers are able to work at that speed, so there is a term called speed bottleneck for the servers. So we should we also have to work on the speed of the servers. So the conclusion is that you can install these cheap light powered internet or the LiFi everywhere, and there is the concept of the internet of things, a concept in which all the digital communication or the all the electronic devices will communicate to each other, will become a reality. So if the LiFi become widely available, so believe me, this technology will change this era to a new world where the internet and the transfer of the information will not be an obstacle. So that's all from my side. Thank you.